Students, coming to the next topic, that is assembler directives. So what is this assembler directive? Actually, this is not any language. So this is only a special codes that are placed in a programming language. Let me write that. Assembler directives is a special code, a special codes placed in the assembly language program. So just we are placing the assembly language program to instruct the assembler to perform a particular task. Particular task of function. So just the assembler directive is just we call it as a special code, and this code is instructing to the assembler. It is giving instructions to the assembler. Assembler is used to convert the high level language into assembly language. So it instructing to the assembler to perform some particular task of a function. It has to do some function on that special code. Okay, so they are used. These assembler directives can be used to define symbol values. Okay, so this can be used to define symbol values, reserve and initialize storage space. So these directives used for symbol values, and they are used for reserving, means it is reserving or initializing some storage space for variables. So whatever the variables that you are declaring, for that variables, these assembler directives is used to help to store the space. Okay, it will reserve the storage space for variables and control the placement of program code. So these are the operations that these assembler directives can perform. So this just we call it as a special codes in the assembly language program. So let us see what are these assembler directives, different types of assembler directives. So the assume is one directive, db is one directive. Db is nothing but defined byte. Dd is one directive. DD is nothing but defined double word. DQ, defined quad word. DT, defined 10 bytes. DW, defined word. So these are the different directives. So these directives is just indicating whether what is a variable, is whether storage of that variable, how much amount of memory it has to be occupied, that variable has to be occupied in the memory, means only the byte size it has to be occupied. Double word, quad word, or it occupies 10 bytes, the whatever the data that is initializing, that data has to be occupied only 10 bytes, or it occupies a word size, like that. Okay, so let me explain first what is assume. Assume is a directive. It is directive used to tell the assembler. So all the directives are used to indicate to the assemblers, means it is giving directions to the assemblers about that special code. It is a directive used to tell the assembler that the name of logical segment, that the name of logical segment should be used for a specified segment. So whatever the logical segment that we are using, that has to be used for the specified segment. So in 8086 works directly with only four physical segments. So we already know the four physical segments that are mostly used in 8086 microprocessor. So those are the code segment, data segment, stack segment, and extra segment. So let me write the declaration of this assume statement. Assume direct example. Just assume, we have assume CS as code. So whenever we know that the 8086 microprocessor and the assembler is also not CS is a code segment. So the another name we are giving for CS is code. So whenever in the program, whenever the code occurs, it's nothing but code segment. This tells the assembler that the logical segment named, what we named the logical segment? Code. Code contains the instruction statements. It contains the complete code, the instruction statement for the program, and should be treated as code segment. So it has to be treated as code segment. So that is the meaning of this statement. Assume CS code. So this is, we call it as a logical state segment. We call CODE is a logical statement which we are given. Okay, we are declaring for CS. So instead of code segment, we are using CODE as a logical name. So in the same way, assume DS data. What it represents? So this tells the assembler that for any instruction which refers to a data, in the data DS, okay, so let me write, this tells the assembler that for any instruction which refers to a data in data segment, and data will found in logical segment data. Okay, so it's just telling to the assembler that DATA contains, it's a data segment which contains the data. So this is about the assume statement. So in the next video, we'll discuss about the remaining directives. Thank you.